Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Welcome my fellow June bugs. Thank you for joining me once again. Today I have an unboxing for you guys. Yep, this just came through. Just got it today and I know your girl needs to stop shopping. I have a serious problem and it's sort of funny how my shopping goes up at the rate of my stress. So clearly it's a really bad coping mechanism. I guess good for my sanity, not good for my bank account. So yeah, I need to find something else to sort of help me cope with stress. But good for you guys because you get to see me spend lots of my hard-earned money on things that I probably don't need. So yay. Alright, here we go, you guys. Sure, there's gonna be people in the comment section talking about how, you know, I need to stop spending my money and blah, blah, blah. I know. You don't need to let me know. I'm fully aware, my friend. I'm fully aware. Alright, so I'm a bit rambly. I'm so sorry. And also, my hair is, I don't know if it's any good. Screw it. So, this is the parcel. Comes in pretty well packaged. I've never seen this bubble wrap before. Like it sort of looks like ice, but yeah, it comes pretty well packaged, you guys. I'm super duper impressed with how their packaging is. So this item I bought from Rakuten, you guys, honestly, like eBay, who I am obsessed with Rakuten, I cannot even tell you. Recently eBay started to put like 10% tax on everything that's purchased overseas, especially if that's under $1,000. So I usually like to buy a lot of small SLGs from overseas, like from Japanese consignment sellers, but when you add like 10% on top, that kind of adds up, especially if you have to pay like shipping or anything like that. So I've not been as enticed with eBay as I have been in the past, I'm not gonna lie. But yeah, because then even with eBay, like even if you have 10% off discount code, it just brings it back to the original price. So it's not that great. Okay, here we go. So you guys, I'm so impressed because this bag I got for such a steal and it is in such good condition, well, according to the website. So let me reveal to you guys my latest handbag purchase. It is a Dior item, and yes, it is very small, but you did hear me say Dior bag, so I'm sure you can guess what is a bag that comes in this size. But here we go, you guys. So gorgeous Dior packaging, just there, opening it up. Comes with the Dior dust bag. It's a bit bright today, so I apologize, and that is all. Okay, so there we go, Dior dust bag to reveal. Hey. Da da da. Oh my God, I did it again. Oh my God, so nice. Yes, girl. What? The condition is freaking stunning. Oh my God, it's still even got the sticker on it. Oh my God, are you serious? Okay, here we go. So okay, let me just stop for a second. So it is the Dior wallet on chain in the micro canage in the silver hardware. It is so good. It is in like freaking excellent condition according to like the shop. It said like pretty much brand new. And it does have like the removable strap, and it is basically the wallet on chain. So this is what it looks like. It's in like patent silver. It does have a little mark there or indentation there, which was described, and they pretty much said that was the only thing wrong with this bag. The only thing is it doesn't come with the card, the Dior card, I don't believe. Whatever, I don't really care because, you know, I got it for such a good price. So I've been looking at this wallet on chain. If you follow me on Instagram, you would have seen I've actually gone to Dior several times looking at this exact same bag. I'm sure the sales associate are very sick of me trying on the exact bag every single time and going, ah, I'll think about it, thanks, okay, bye. I've been so annoying, but I was looking at it in the silver and the gold, and I've always felt like I wanted the gold. I've just dimmed it down a bit so you can actually see the detail of this bag. I've always kept an eye on this bag in the silver and the gold, and I've always wanted it in the gold. I just thought that the gold was the cutest thing ever, and I really wanted a gold metallic bag considering that I have the Loewe silver bag. So I wanted one of each metallic bag, because you guys, if you've never owned a metallic bag, you cannot even imagine how very neutral and very easy to style they are. It is so, like, you need one in your handbag collection, like, truthfully. You know, everyone talks about like black and beige and brown, but like gold and silver are two other colors that you, or two other shades, I don't know, metallics that you really need in your handbag collection, because they're so neutral. You can pair them with anything and everything. And I got the silver style because it was basically the only one that I found pre-loved. But the reason that I jumped the gun on this one instead of paying full price for the gold was basically how much I could get this for. So this bag retails brand new in store for $2,420. Now, I was like, okay, it's not too bad, because I do have like David Jones gift cards, and I was like, oh, if I can save enough to get it down under $2,000, I'm happy to pay it. But in saying that, you know, I have to have like about $500 in David Jones gift cards to do that, and even then it will still be, you know, just under $2,000. This, my friends, I got for $1,600 Australian dollars. And I got cash back on it using my eBay. So I think they had about, I don't quite remember what the cash back was I think 10%. So I got an additional $160 off it, which is insane. So, okay, basically I got this bag for $1,500 Australian dollars, and I still have my David Jones gift cards that I can use for something else. So I'm super stoked about it. Yes, I wish it was in the gold, but I love the silver anyways. Like, I do have my gold Chanel Classic flap. Well, my black classic flap in the gold hardware. So that will be like my gold clutch. But this one will be like a perfect clutch for nights out. And what sold me on this bag, because initially I was umming and ahhing about it like for the longest time, because I was like, ugh, it's so long still. Like, I don't know, should I? Is the strap is, yes, long. But when I went to the Sydney, Dior store, they did this little trick, and I was like, oh my God, how has no one ever done that before? So, okay, this strap, you guys, is detachable, right? So normally you attach it onto each D ring there. What you actually do instead of attaching it is you sling it through. I was like, what? I never knew you could do that. So you could actually thread it through. Like, you can thread the strap through. What the hell? I was so blown away when she did that. I was like, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, you've just revolutionized this bag. And now it is a shorter strap, and you don't even have to worry about it coming undone. You don't have to worry about it wrecking the leather. None of that. It's perfect. It's functional, and it is the perfect length for me, because I'm 5 foot tall, and so this length is perfect. So if I ever see the gold, I'm probably going to get it, because I'm obsessed with this like micro canage metallic print. I'm so obsessed with it. I freaking love it. I'm so stunned. Oh my God, I'm just blown away. So yes, guys, that is my new bag. So I'm not wearing the nicest pants, so I apologize, but this is how the bag looks on me. Is it not the cutest freaking thing you've ever seen in your life, you guys? You guys. It doesn't, I don't think it fits as much as a Chanel wallet on chain, but you guys, it's so cute. All right, so I do think that all of the Dior wallet on chains can do that. So if you are after a wallet on chain, definitely have a look at the Dior wallet on chains because the chain is detachable, so you can actually wear this as a strap and not have to worry about the fact that the chain takes up all of the space inside the wallet itself. You can wear it as a clutch bag for, you know, nights out. Honestly, I'm still like wanting the gold. What's wrong with me? I don't know. I really like this bag, and I've been looking at it for such a long time, and I'm so surprised that I didn't put it in my wish list, because this was definitely something I've had on my wish list. So I probably should have given that wish list a bit more thought. I think I was just so excited about having like Hermes on my wish list that I just forgot about all the other stuff that I've been thinking about and visiting and like, yeah, obsessing about. So hey Dior, what's up? Hello. So that is my new bag, you guys. That is my gorgeous new wallet on chain. I'm so obsessed with it. I freaking love it. Let me know what you guys think. Do you think I should have gotten the silver or the gold? In saying that, the gold is a bit more of like a champagne gold. It's not as striking as the silver. Anyways, you guys, that is it. That is my handbag unboxing. I'm so excited to wear that, to use it. Let me know what you guys think. If you enjoyed this video, do make sure to give it a thumbs up. If you like these types of videos, subscribe if you haven't already. And don't forget to hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on future videos, because unfortunately, you know, YouTube doesn't always show new videos on your subscription feed, which is so annoying. Hope you guys are having a wonderful week or weekend, and I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.